All right, now that you know what Angular is, let's take a look at the architecture of Angular applications. A lot of modern applications have at least two parts, a front-end and a back-end. The front-end, also called the client, is the part that runs in the web browser, and this is what the user sees and interacts with. So it essentially includes the user interface or UI of an application. We use HTML, CSS, TypeScript, and Angular to build the front-end. The back-end sits on a web server, or multiple web servers in the cloud, and is responsible for storing the data and doing any kind of processing. Our front-end, or the client app, talks to the back-end to get or save the data. One of the questions that a lot of beginners ask me is, Mosh, how do I save my data in Angular? Well, you don't. In most cases, you don't save the data on the client, because it can easily disappear as the user clears the browser data or moves to a different computer. That's why we store the data on the server. So here we often have one or more databases, as well as a bunch of HTTP services or APIs to make this data available to the clients. In case you don't know, API stands for Application Programming Interface. Now, if you put this fancy name aside, these HTTP services or APIs are essentially endpoints that are accessible via the HTTP protocol. So we can call them using simple HTTP requests to get or to save the data. If that's too much technical jargon here, let me give you a metaphor. Think of a port where ships load or unload. These are points to get loads in and out of a town, right? Now imagine these ports are HTTP endpoints, ships are HTTP requests, and loads are data. So just like we can send a ship to a port to get some load and bring to us, a client app sends an HTTP request to an endpoint to get some data. So this is how the big picture works. Our web applications have a front end and a back end. On the back end, we have one or more databases and APIs that make the data available to the clients. For a large application around a complex domain, this is where we implement the business logic of the application, like calculating the tax and shipping cost based on various parameters. The front end or the client, on the other hand, is all about the presentation. So here we have our HTML templates, as well as the presentation logic of our application. This logic is all about displaying data and responding to user actions, like what should happen when the user clicks on a button or navigates away from a page. These are examples of the presentation logic, or the logic that is all about the presentation aspects of an application. Now, in terms of the implementation, building the backend requires familiarity with other languages and frameworks, and that's completely outside the scope of building client apps with Angular. So as an Angular or a front-end developer, you don't have to worry about this. This is the job of a backend developer or a full stack developer who knows both the front end and the back end. So for the purpose of this course, we're going to focus on the front end. And if you want to learn about the back end development, you can always pick up a course later down the road. But for now, let's just focus on one thing and do it well.